you might want to think twice before getting into one of these cars. Welcome to WatchMojo, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 auto recalls and scandals. For this list, we're looking at scandals involving automotive companies that resulted in recalls. Some of these entries not only resulted in recalls, but injury, death, as well as damage toward public and private property. Not to mention the significant damage done to the reputation of these brands. Why are more young adults drawn to socialism? Can billionaires be trusted to fix capitalism?
I think that the wealth gap and the opportunity gap is the biggest issue of our time.
Can entrepreneurs level the playing field? Be sure to check out Fox in the Henhouse, a brand new documentary streaming in full on Context TV. Find the link below. Number 10, Takata seatbelts. In 1995, reports of faulty seatbelts produced by Japanese automotive parts manufacturer Takata were sent to the US National Highway Traffic Safety Administration. That same year, a recall was issued for seatbelts in no less than 8 million cars from 1986 to 1991. The defect in these Takata-produced belts was the plastic, which would turn brittle when exposed to sunlight for long periods of time. This led to either the buckle breaking, providing no protection, or jamming, trapping the user. Despite no deaths being reported, there were around 50 injuries. The recall didn't just affect one make either. Takata belts were used by many brands, including Honda, Nissan, Mazda, Subaru, and even some GM, Ford, and Chrysler models. Number 9. Ford defective ignitions. In 1996, Ford issued the second largest recall in its history, recalling 8.7 million cars from 1988 to 1993 for a defective ignition switch. These ignitions had the possibility of short-circuiting, causing the steering column to overheat and sometimes light on fire. According to the complaints sent to Ford, more than 1,000 fires were caused by this defect in the US and Canada. These fires not only destroyed multiple cars, but also caused fires in some homes when cars were parked in garages. There were also injuries reportedly caused by these fires, 21 being from the US and an additional 9 from Canada. Number 8. General Motors engine mounts. GM issued the then largest recall in the US in 1971, reluctantly recalling around 6.7 million cars. The issue concerned the engine mounts of certain cars, which could break, allowing the engine to move freely. This caused damage, naturally, to multiple parts of the car, leading to issues like unintended acceleration and not being able to switch into park. While this was bad enough, GM actually knew about the issue before the US National Highway Traffic Safety Administration approached them. However, the case was put on hold until more reports came in and the media reported on the issue. GM did eventually recall the defective vehicles, however, they maintained the issue should not be labeled a safety defect. Number 7. Fiat Chrysler hacking. In 2015, Fiat Chrysler recalled 1.4 million cars due to a software flaw, which could allow hackers to gain control of a vehicle's engine, brakes, and even steering. Two hackers, Charlie Miller and Chris Valasek, had developed software that could exploit this flaw and told Chrysler before making their findings public, hoping it would fix the issue.
Anything in the car that was controllable over the in-car network, we were able to do.
You talk about last time, before when you showed us how to hack a car, you had to do it from within the car with a laptop. So tell me, what is different now?
Yeah, now we don't have to be in the car. We don't have to be connected. We don't even have to be in the same state. So we can reach any car in the United States and potentially North America.
Initially, Fiat Chrysler planned on issuing an update through their website and notifying their customers. However, the NHTSA told Chrysler an official recall was necessary due to the potential dangers towards the public. The company then issued a recall for certain vehicles with touchscreens, making it the first official recall due to a hacking threat. Number 6. General Motors ignition switch defect. Appearing again with a more recent scandal, in 2014, GM issued a recall for 2.6 million cars sold with an ignition switch defect. The faulty part could easily slip out of run and into accessory mode, thereby disabling the power steering, braking, and airbags.
To ensure the vehicles are safe, if you use only a single key on the key ring.
This issue first arose in 2001, according to internal GM documents, but was supposedly fixed. The issue was again addressed in 2015, but instead of issuing a recall, GM paid out individual claims. This scandal eventually led to a recall of around 30 million cars worldwide and millions of dollars in fines, with the confirmed death toll being over 100.
Today's GM will do the right thing. That begins with my sincere apologies to everyone who has been affected by this recall.
Number 5, Ford and Firestone, tread separation. Ford and Firestone didn't start the new millennium off on a good note. In 2000, the U.S. National Highway Traffic Safety Administration started an investigation based on complaints received about Ford SUVs and their Firestone tires. The first complaints included 4 deaths. However, after the investigation, more than 100 confirmed deaths were reported due to a defect in the tires.
We value your safety, blah, 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 but we can't help you.
The Ford recall comes one day after Firestone severed its relationship with Ford, a relationship that began when Harvey Firestone agreed to supply tires for Henry Ford's Model T.
The issue came down to the tread of the faulty tires, which could rip apart at random moments, leading to the vehicles rolling over. Unsurprisingly, Ford and Firestone issued multiple recalls, totaling around 19.5 million tires. Both companies blamed each other for the issue, and it subsequently ended their long business relationship.
This is a tire issue, and only a tire issue.
First, let me assure you that the Firestone tires that are on the road today are completely safe.
Firestone's chairman, John Lampe, of course, argued that Ford and its Explorer design are at fault.
Number 4, Volkswagen, emission scandal. In 2015, the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency announced that Volkswagen was using software in their diesel cars to cheat emissions tests. The software detected when the car was being tested and scaled back emissions, but when driven normally, the car would revert back. It was estimated that these cars produced 40 times more pollutants than what is allowed in the U.S. Later that year, Volkswagen announced that around 11 million cars were affected worldwide, with 500,000 being in the U.S. Volkswagen issued multiple recalls, including a buyback program, and spent billions to cover fines and give compensation to their customers. Multiple executives, including the CEO, resigned, and some were fired. Number 3, Takata, deadly airbags. Almost 20 years after their first major recall, Takata was deep into an even bigger scandal, this time involving airbags. In 2013, it was discovered that chemicals inside a metal canister in their airbags were defective, causing the canister to explode with greater force than intended, sending metal shrapnel into the cabin of the car. Over 30 million cars from 10 different manufacturers were found to be defective and recalled.
Since excessive moisture seems to be the main cause of the defect, car makers are targeting humid parts of the U.S., like the Gulf Coast, for the recall.
Honda alone recalled millions of cars. However, the company took their time alerting the public. In total, 13 deaths and over 100 injuries are reportedly tied to this defect.
My vision will never be the same. I will never be the same.
Number 2, the Ford Pinto, deadly rear-end collisions. The Pinto entered the market with mixed reviews, but they shifted significantly in 1977 when Mother Jones magazine published a report highlighting its most major defect. When rear-ended, the Pinto's fuel tank could easily rupture and ignite. The magazine also reported that Ford knew about this defect, but rather than redesign or issue recalls, decided to compensate possible victims due to the cost. Ford was then indicted for negligent homicide after the deaths of 3 teenage girls. However, the company was acquitted. In 1978, Ford finally issued a recall, installing parts to deflect contact with the fuel tank if rear-ended. In later years, some have questioned how severe the defect was and how public opinion might have led to exaggerations. Before we continue, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. You have the option to be notified for occasional videos or all of them. If you're on your phone, make sure you go into your settings and switch on notifications. Number 1, Toyota, unintended acceleration. In 2009, Toyota recalled millions of vehicles due to multiple defects that resulted in unintended acceleration.
5 deaths have been blamed on this unintended acceleration, and the recall was prompted by a crash outside San Diego last summer that killed 4 family members.
What led to this recall? A family of 4's last moments as they described the issue to 911 operators. Some Toyotas had the unfortunate flaw of the gas pedal sticking or getting snagged in the floor mat, causing unintended acceleration. What's more shocking is that Toyota knew about this issue and even recalled around 50,000 mats in 2007. However, they failed to issue a major recall or even change the design of the mat.
Absolutely devastating for everybody. It's hard for my aunt to really even go on with her life.
12 deaths were linked to the defect, and Toyota was fined for attempting to keep the issue quiet. Do you agree with our picks? Check out this other recent clip from WatchMojo, and be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.